Hi guys, welcome back. If you love Linux but want the familiar look and feel of Windows, then you are in the right video. Today I will show you how to install Winux, or you can say Wubuntu, which is the Linux operating system completely inspired by the Microsoft Windows. And it's also lightweight, fast and great alternative for those who want to Windows-like experience with the power of Linux. And the best part is, you can even install it on an older machine. So let's quickly get started. Before we begin, we need to download the Winux or Wubuntu ISO file. So let me show you how. So you need to open your web browser and go to the wubuntu.org site. Here it is clearly mentioned that Winux is a super secret Linux operating system that is completely inspired by Microsoft Windows, but does not require any special hardware requirements and can be installed on any devices. It's also familiar for Windows users. Winux is the only system that has built in the tool most used by Windows users, like the Edge browser, OneDrive, Team, etc. Okay, so simply click on download and this page will come up. Here you can see the what's the new in this version and the minimum hardware requirements to install this. It requires 64 bit CPU, minimum 3 GB of RAM, recommended 4 GB, and 16 GB of hard disk. Once your device meets the specification, click on download Winux. After that, click on download latest version, which is Windows Linux 11.25.03 LTS. After a few seconds, your download will start automatically. And as you can see, the ISO file size is around 4.5 GB, so it may take some time to download depending on your internet speed, okay? Once downloaded, remember where the file is saved, because we will need it later. Now you can install Winux on an old PC using a bootable USB drive, or you can use dual boot with your existing OS. But in this video, I will be installing it inside a virtual machine called VirtualBox. If you don't know how to install VirtualBox, I have already made a separate video on that. The link is in the description. Now I am going to open VirtualBox, and once open, click on new to create a new virtual machine. In the name field, you need to type Winux or Wubuntu, whatever you like. Under ISO image, select the Winux ISO file that you have downloaded earlier. Then check the box skip unattended installation. Then click next. In the memory allocation, set the memory of RAM is up to 4096 MB, that is 4 GB. And the same way, processor allocation you can set at 4 cores. Then click on next. You need to select create a virtual hard disk now and set the disk size to minimum 30 GB. You can allocate more if you have enough space. Okay. Now click on next. Then click on finish. Before starting, click on settings, then go to display and increase video memory to maximum. Then click on OK. Now the virtual machine setup is ready. Let's install Winux. So you need to click on start to boot from the ISO file. Here, installer will take some time. After a few seconds, you will see the Winux screen, which looks just like Windows 11. However, the installation is not complete yet. Now click on install Winux 11 LTS to proceed with the setup. Once the setup starts, you will be asked a few questions. So first, you need to choose your preferred language and click next. Here you need to select your location, then click next. And in choose keyboard layout, default is the fine for the most users. Then click next. In this page, you need to choose erase disks, but don't worry, this won't affect your real PC, only the virtual disks. Then click on next. Then you need to enter your name over here, then login name, computer name, and create a password for the same. And you need to repeat the password. If you want, you can check the box for login automatically without asking for the password. Then click on next. Then click on install. Now it will be asking for your permission. Just click on install now and the installation will begin. Now you just need to wait for some time while it completes. The process may take a few minutes depending on your system speed, so just sit back and relax. Once installation is done, you will see the confirmation message and click Restart Now. When prompted, remove the installation media. Don't worry, virtual machine does this automatically. Then press Enter and your system will reboot, and now you will see Winux booting up. After booting, you will see the Winux desktop. It looks just like a Windows, right? Now that we have Winux, or you can say Ubuntu, installed, and you might notice that the screen is stuck in a small window. To enable full screen mode and improve performance, we need to install VirtualBox Guest Edition. So click on Devices in the VirtualBox menu at the top, select Insert Guest Edition CD image, then mount it and open the folder. Then double click on VBox Windows Edition AMD64.exe file. Then click on Execute. Guest Edition setup page will open up. Click on Next, again click on Next, then click on Install and let the installation complete. Once the installation is done, restart your virtual machines again, and after that click on View in the virtual box and select full screen mode, and you should see the Winux expand to your full screen just like a real operating system. Alright, so let's take a look at Winux, or you can say Ubuntu, and explore some of its interface. Okay, on the left hand side you will notice the weather widget. Let me click on it, and you can see just like any other weather app, you can configure your location over here. So let's set this up quickly, and that's it. Now the weather widget is working perfectly, and there is also a widget panel. Here you can customize this widget just the way you like, and here you will also get Microsoft Edge is also included here. It looks exactly the same as the Windows version because, well, it is a Microsoft Edge only. Now let's check out some of the icon at the bottom. So moving on, let's open the File Explorer, and at a first glance it looks identical to Windows Explorer, you can see. But since this is not actually Windows, it's a Linux based file manager with a Windows style theme. The developer have done a great job making it look and feel like Windows, isn't it? So now clicking on this icon called Discover, it looks like a software store similar to the Microsoft store. Here you will see a variety of apps with different categories like accessibility. You will get different types of tools over here and accessories, small but useful utilities like text editor, extension manager and file manager, and developer tool. Here you will get some essential software for coding, debugging, and in education, here you will get a learning app, study tools, and lots of educational resources for all ages. And games, there you'll get lots of classic and modern games to keep you entertained. As well as you can also get graphics. You will get color paint, blender types of image editor, and design tools. You will see a variety of apps that you can either install or launch directly. So some apps comes pre-installed. So let's try one. I will click on VLC Media Player, and you can see the launch button here. Let's click on it, and there you go. VLC open up instantly. So now let's install FileZilla. You need to put your password over here. Then it will be downloaded and installed very quickly. You can check all the application and software updates information from here. Now if you go to the settings, you will notice it looks almost identical to the Windows 11 settings panel. However, this is actually PowerToys control, which is just themed to look like Windows 11 settings. Winux also comes with a virtual desktop, you can see. Now let's check the version details of Wubuntu. You will see a search icon named Run. Click on it. In the search box, you need to type Terminal. And in the search suggestion, you will see Console Terminal. Inside the terminal, you need to type lsb_release-a and press Enter. This will display detailed information about your Winux or Wubuntu version. including the release number and code name. You can see. So in order to shut down your Winux or Wubuntu properly, click on Start menu, then look for the power icon, and you will see options like shutdown, restart, and logout. Select shutdown and the system will turn off. So that's how you install Winux or Wubuntu in VirtualBox. It's a great way to experience Linux with a Windows-like theme without changing your main system. So if you found this guide helpful, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more easy tech tutorials. That's it for today's guide. See you in the next video.